भगवते वासुदेवाय
ॐ
नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
ॐ
नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेषु वभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवति उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति
नैष्टिकी.
We're reading Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Chapter 28, Text Number 39.
今天我们学习的是圣典薄伽瓦坛第十一篇二十八章第三十九节。
Yoga.
Yoga.
Dharanaya.
Kamschit
Asanya
Asanya
Dharan An Anvitai
Dharanvitai
Tapo
Tapo
Mantroshadai
Mantroshadai
Kamschit Upasargan
Upasargan
Vinirdahet
Vinirdahet
Yoga Dharanaya Kanschit
Yoga Dharanaya Kanschit
Asaner Dharanan Vitai
Asaner Dharanan Vitai
Tapo Mantro Shadai Kanschit
Tapo Mantro Shadai Kanschit
Upasargam Vinirdahet Yoga Dharanaya Kamschit
Yoga Dharanaya Kamschit
Asana Dharanan Vitai
Asana Dharanan Vitai
Tapo Mantro Shadai Kamschit
Tapo Mantro Shadai Kamschit
Upasargan Vinirdahet
Upasargan
Yoga Dharanaya Kamschit
Yoga Dharanaya Kamschit
Asana Dharanan Vitai
Asana Dharanan Vitai
Tapo Mantro Shadai Kamschit
Tapo Mantro Shadai Kamschit
Upasargan Vinirdahet
Upasargan Vinirdahet
Asanai Dharanan Vitai
Tapo Mantro Shadai
chit.
Tapo mantra sadai comes chit.
Upasargam vinirdhahet.
Upasargam vinirdhahet.
Yoga pandranaya touch chit.
Yoga pandranaya comes chit. Asa-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra-ra Kam chit.
What meaning?
You want me to check?
Yoga Dharanaya Kamsit.
Yoga Dharanaya Kamsit.
Asanai Dharanavitai.
Asanai Dharanavitai.
Tapo Mantra Sadai Kamsit.
Tapo Mantra Sadai Kamsit.
Upasargam Vinirdahit.
Upasargam Vinirdahit.
Yoga Dharanaya
by yogic meditation
通过瑜伽冥想
comes chit
some disturbances
一些困扰
asanai by
prescribed postures
通过规定动作
Dharanaya Anvitai together with meditation on controlled breathing Tapa by special austerities. Mantra.
Magical chants. 神秘的念诵.
Oshadai. And medicinal herbs.
和药草.
Translation. Some of these obstructions may be counteracted by yogic meditation or by sitting postures practiced together with concentration on controlled breathing, and others may be counteracted by special austerities, mantras, or medicinal herbs.
译文，其中一些阻碍可以通过与专注的调息相结合的瑜伽冥想，或 体味予以抵消。另一些可以通过特定的苦行 mantra 或药草抵消。
There's no purport. We'll read the next verse.
那么这个师姐呢没有药旨，所以我们会读下面一个师姐。
These inauspicious disturbances can be gradually removed by constant remembrance of me, by congregational hearing and chanting of my holy names, or by following in the footsteps of the great masters of yoga.
译文：通过恒常想着我，集体聆听和唱诵我的圣名，或者通过追随伟大瑜伽师的步伐，这些不吉祥的困扰能逐渐被清除掉。
Purport: According to Srila Sridhar Swami, by meditation on the Supreme Lord, one can overcome lust and other mental disturbances. And by following in the footsteps of great transcendentalists, one can overcome hypocrisy, false pride, and other types of mental imbalance.
要知是释迦牟尼说，通过冥想至尊主，一个人能征服色欲和其他心智困扰；通过追随伟大超然主义者的步伐，一个人能超越幻象、虚假的骄傲和其他心智失衡。
Om Jnana Timurandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Taksurmilitanena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhistam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupakadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Bandeham Shri Guru Shri Yata PadakamalamShri Gurun Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sakrajatam Sahagana Raghunathan Vitam Tam Sajevam Sadvaitam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakanitamscha Hey Krishna Karana Sindhu Dinabandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gorange Radhe Vrindavanishwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare So, Lord Krishna is giving advice to Uddhava on the practice of yoga and he's describing how sometimes there will be obstacles in the practice of yoga.
So, Krishna is talking to Uddhava. 他对 Uddhava 在说呢，就是在瑜伽的习练当中如何去除在修行的道路上的一些障碍。
And practice of yoga, of course, there will be challenges, there will be difficulties which the yogi has to meet.
当然在瑜伽修炼的过程当中呢，一定会遇到一些困难或者是一些障碍。
So here in the verse, today we're hearing one of the obstacles can be lust.And other mental disturbances.
所以在今天的世界当中，我们会听到的是，在这个 诸多的障碍当中呢，其中一个就是色欲啊，或者是这些心智上的啊一些打扰。
Mental disturbances. Our minds are always agitated. We're always thinking different. Want to do things, change things.
那么心智的打扰是什么意思呢？就是总是想要做各种各样不同的事情，或者总是有变来变去。
Mental, the mind will tell us things like, "Oh, I don't like this person. Oh, I don't like this service. Oh, I don't like this place."
这个心智的打扰意味着说啊，我不喜欢这个服务啊，我不喜欢这个人啊，我不喜欢啊这样或者那样。
Like the mind will always present many different alternatives to us.
所以呢，这个心念呢，它会给到我们很多不同的。选择给到我们，或者是其他的这些方式给到我们。
So, the mind, we know in Bhagavad Gita, when Lord Krishna described the yoga process to Arjuna, Arjuna also said it's very difficult to control the mind.
所以在《薄伽梵歌》当中，当主 Krishna 在讲述各种的瑜伽程序的时候 ，Krishna 也在跟 Arjuna 在描述这个心念呢是非常难以控制的。
Arjuna told Krishna his mind was more restless than the wind.
Arjuna 对 Krishna 说，他的这个心念呢，心念不安不稳，甚至是比这个狂风还要不安稳。
And although Arjuna was saying his mind was restless and difficult to control, Lord Krishna didn't really accept.
当 Arjuna 向 Krishna 讲述到这个他的这个心念是很难控制的时候，主 Krishna 并没有真正的接受他的观点。
Lord Krishna told Arjuna that it may be a difficult business to control the mind, but it's possible by constant practice and by detachment.
那么主 Krishna 呢就对 Arjuna 说，一个人可以通过不断的习练以及气绝的心态来控制心念。
And here in this verse Lord Krishna is giving a little different process by which one can control the mind.
那么在
He mentions about meditation on the Supreme Lord.
那么在今天的这个世界当中的话呢，主 Krishna 就给到 Arjuna 一些不同的控制心念的方式。他讲到了去冥想这尊主。
Meditation on the Supreme Lord can help to bring the mind under control and take away all the material desires.
那么对主的冥想呢，可以让我们能够控制心念，并且去去除或者控制我们的这些物质的愿望。
And controlling the mind, meditation on the Supreme Lord, of course, in the Kali Yuga is achieved through the chanting of the holy name.
当然在卡利年代当中呢，我们真正的要控制心念的方式就是通过吟诵圣名。
We want to overcome lust, we want to overcome the mental disturbances. If we take shelter of the holy name, then it will certainly help us to overcome these obstacles.
我们想要去控制心念，控制心念的这些，或者是预防心念的这些打扰，那么通过去吟诵圣名的话，我们想就能够很容易的去控制心念，去除色欲。
So therefore, Lord Chaitanya has said, "Kirtaniya Sada Hari." Always chant the holy name.
这就是为什么主 Chaitanya 就说 Kirtaniya Sada Hari， 也就是说我们要很长的吟诵圣名。
And then the second part of the verse talks about another process by which we can overcome obstacles。
这个诗节第二个部分就告诉我们跨越心念的这个打扰的第二种方式。
This process is to follow in the footsteps of great transcendentalists.
也就是说要去追随那些伟大的超然主义者的步伐。
And the obstacles I mentioned which we can overcome, you can overcome things like hypocrisy.
那么我们这个方式呢可以帮助我们去跨越这个一些障碍，这个哪些障碍呢？比如说是那些虚伪。
Hypocrisy, saying one thing to be another.
也就是这个虚伪是什么意思呢？就是把一件事情看作是另外一种。
Somebody says, somebody may say, I'm a rich person, but they're not rich at all.
有人可能会说我是一个非常富有的人，但其实呢，他们并不富有。
Or I'm a great scholar.We don't know anything.
有人可能声称说我是一个很伟大的学者，但其实呢，他什么都不懂。
And then false pride is also mentioned.
在这里还提到了虚假的骄傲。
False pride is what we call in Sanskrit is ahankar.
在梵文当中，我们把虚假的骄傲称为 ahankar.
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes how.By the influence of ahankar, we think ourselves to be the doer of activities.
在不在梵歌当中，主 Krishna 就说到了。那么在 ahankar 当中，在 ahankar 的覆盖之下的话，一个人会认为他是作为者。
Prakrite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvashah ahankara vimudatma kartaham iti manyate.The bewildered spirit soul, under the influence of material nature, thinks himself to be the doer of activities which are actually carried out by the modes of nature.
那么受困惑的体困灵魂就是以为他自己是活动的作为者，但其实呢这些活动都是由物质自然三形态来执行的。
I did it, but actually we're just simply instruments
我们会想着说是我做的，是我做的，但其实呢我们只是一个工具而已。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna tells Arjuna, Nimitta Matra Bhava Savyasachin, just become an instrument in my service, Arjuna.
在《博哉梵歌》当中， Krishna 对 Arjuna 说，只是成为我的 Arjuna, 你只是成为我的工具而已。
And Lord Krishna gives Arjuna credit. He says, Savyasachin, you're a great archer. You can fire arrows even in the dark. And you can do many great military, you have many great skills.
而 Krishna 呢而 Krishna 同时也把这个荣耀做这些事情的荣耀给了 Arjuna。 他说，他对 Arjuna 说， Savyasachi， 你是伟大的弓箭手你很非常非常的厉害。
But even though you have these skills, just remember your mood, your proper mood should be to think of yourself as an instrument in my service.
那么即便你是有那么精湛的技艺，有那么大的这个能力，但是你总是要保持，要意识到你只是在我的服务当中的一个工具而已。
So false pride is to think of ourselves independent of the Supreme Lord.
所以虚假的骄傲便意味着说一个人认为自己是独立于至尊主的。
Just like sometimes the young man will declare his independence of his father and go off on his own to seek his own fortune.
就好像是一个年轻人他宣布说他跟他的他是从他的这个家庭或者从他的父亲那里独立出来了，然后呢他离家出走去寻找他的这个幸福。
Now the young, Often young people have that mood, the independent mood, that I can do it on my own.
通常呢，年轻人都有这样的一种啊独立的心态，觉得说，哎，我自己什么都能干了，没问题。
And so, Lord Krishna also mentions that other types of mental imbalance.
Krishna 在这里也讲到了其他的心智的障碍。
So you see, these different obstacles are all due to different conditions of the mind.
所以呢，我们会看到，其实所有这些不同的这些障碍的话呢，都是跟心智有关的。
If we can train our mind to be submissive and to be obedient, then the battle can be won easily.
所以呢，如果我们能够去训练我们的心念，去控制我们的心念的话，那么我们就可以更加容易的来赢得这场战役。
Anyway, Lord Krishna mentions the solution to overcome these obstacles is to follow in the footsteps of great transcendentalists.
所以Krishna 给 Arjuna 的这个建议就是，我们如果想要去跨越这些心智的失衡的话，那么就意味着我们要去追随这些超然伟大的超然主义者的步伐。
This is mentioned by Grandfather Bhishma in Mahabharata.
那么在这是在 Mahabharata 当中Bhishma 祖父也是有提及。
The verse is also there in the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
这个师姐呢，也是在永恒的 Chaitanya 经当中有提到。
Dargo pratishta shritayo vibina na savrishir yashya natam vibinam dhammasya tatvam nitam guhayam mahajano yena gita sapanta. So,Grandfather Bhishma is describing that how to understand the absolute truth.
那么 Bhishma 祖父呢，他在描述的是如何来理解至尊真理，绝对真理。
Tarko pratishta, that dry arguments are inconclusive.
Dry argument is not incomplete.
Dry arguments, just simply arguing without any real purpose in mind.
Okay. 所以呢，这个枯燥的这些辩论的话呢，就是说，其实，在他们就是说是没有什么目的性的。
And Shrutayo Vibhina, the Shruti, the Vedas are also difficult to come to any real conclusion.
书体 Veda 这些经典的话呢，其实也并没有真正的给予什么真正的结论。
One scripture says one thing, and another scripture says another.
一个经典呢，它是这么说的；另外一个经典呢，又是那样说。
One place it says Vishnu is the supreme, another place it says Shiva is the supreme.
一个经典说 Vishnu 是至尊，而另外个经典呢，又说是。
And somewhere else is speaking about the Brahman is ultimate. The Brahman is the supreme.
然后又有人说 Brahman 是至尊。
So just simply studying the Vedas, you become bewildered, become confused.
所以呢，如果你只是去学习这些伟大文献的话，那么你的这个心智的话也会觉得受到困扰，或者说有疑惑。
And then Nasavrishya Yasham Natam Vibhino. That the rishis, they will come up with their own theories. One rishi will come up with a conclusion and he will be established as the supreme. And then someone will defeat him. And then a new person will become supreme.
然后呢，这些 Rishi 们，他们比如说都会建立、树立他们自己的理论，然后呢，成为最受追捧的。但是另外会有之后呢，又会有其他的 Rishi 们会有更高的理论出来，又打败前面的这些Rishi 们。
Just like in the times of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, there was one pundit. Keshava Kashmiri, and he took the title of Digvijaya, which means he conquered everywhere.
那么就好像 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的时代，有这样一个 Rishi， 他的名字叫 Keshava Kashmiri， 那么他被称为是 Digvijaya 就是征服四方之人。
So he came to Navadvip and he met with Nimai Pandit and he was defeated.
那么他来到 Navadvip， 然后呢就跟 Nimai Pandit 要跟他有这样的辩论，最终呢他被打败了。
And so in this way you can go on arguing, debating, you never come to any conclusion.
所以呢，就是以这样的方式的话，一个人可以就这样继续不断的找人去辩论，这是永远没有终结的，那也没有什么真正的意义。
So the Sanskrit sloka says, "Dharmasya tadvam nihitam guhayam," that the absolute truth is hidden in the hearts of the devotees.
所以呢，这个师姐就告诉我们，绝对真理它其实是被隐藏在主的超然的奉献者的心中。
Mahajano yenagata sapanta, and you can understand the absolute truth by following in the footsteps of these great devotees.
所以呢，你可以通过追随这个伟大的奉献者的步伐来得到这个绝对的真理。
And so we see in the one verse here two methods of overcoming obstacles, but they're actually the same thing.
所以在这里我们会看到，这个世界里就给到我们两种方式来去除掉这些障碍，但其实呢，这两种方式都是一回事儿。
Because first of all, he's saying meditate on the Supreme Lord.
因为首先他提到的第一种方法就讲到了去冥想至尊主。
And then he's saying follow in the footsteps of the great devotees.
然后第二种方法呢，这就讲到是追随至尊主的伟大的奉献者。
But the great devotees are all meditating on the Supreme Lord.
因为至尊主的伟大奉献者，他们都时常很长的冥想至尊主。
And so the best process to overcome all the obstacles in the path of self-realization is taking shelter of the Supreme Lord.
所以呢，最终我们想要去把这个灵性道路上的所有障碍要去去除的话，便意味着说，我们要托庇于至尊主。
Yeah, we want to follow in the footsteps of great devotees. It's very important for us. We are following Srila Prabhupada. We are Prabhupada Anugas.
我们想要去就是追随伟大奉献者的步伐，这是非常重要的。我们要去追随Srila Prabhupada的步伐。
We're also called Rupa Nugas, followers in the footsteps of Srila Rupa Goswami.
我们也被称为是 Rupa Nuga, 也就是说我们是追随 Rupa Goswami 的步伐。
We want to follow these great devotee, but following in their footsteps means recognizing their spiritual practices and adopting them in our own life.
那么追随伟大奉献者的步伐意味着说要在我们自己的生活当中去真正的追随他们的步伐，并且去在生活当中去践行。
So we see Rupa Goswami, he had retired to Vrindavan. So does it mean we also have to go and retire to Vrindavan?
我们看到 Rupa Goswami 他在 Vrindavan 呢，就是全心的投入就是全心的投入到服务当中那么这是否意味着说我们也都要去 Vrindavan 呢？
Well, certainly it's very nice if you can go to Vrindavan and retire. You're very fortunate.
当然，如果我们能够去 Vrindavan 然后去退休的话，这是非常幸运的。
However, we know know the present. We know the present time. It's difficult for devotees to get visas to go there.
但是呢，我们知道现在奉献者要去那里要得到签证的话，也没有办法做到。
How long you can stay there?
而且你又能在那待多久呢
？When the visa is finished, then you have to go.
这个签证到期了，你就得走了。
Several devotees wanted to stay in Mayapur, but they were not allowed.
有一些奉献者呢，他们想要待在 Mayapur， 但是没有办法长期的待在那里，是不被允许的。
So does it mean we cannot follow Rupa Goswami？
这是否意味着说我们就没有办法去追随 Rupa Goswami 了呢
？No, we can still follow Rupa Goswami. We have to follow his teachings.
不是，我们仍然可以追随 Rupa Goswami， 我们要去追随他的教导。
He teaches us to chant the holy name. He teaches us how to perform devotional service.
他教导我们如何吟诵圣名，教导我们如何从事奉爱服务。
And devotional service doesn't depend on the physical situation.
而奉爱服务呢，并不去依赖于比如说。外在的这些条件。
Just like the other day, we were telling about the Gopikanyas, about the Yajnapatnis, the wives of the Brahmanas. Thank you.
就好像前几天我们就讲到了，这些Yajnapatni， 这些婆罗门的妻子们。
And they had left her home to go to Krishna.And they wanted to just stay with Krishna, but Krishna sent them home.
他们呢想要他们离开了家庭，他们想要离开家庭，一直跟 Krishna 在一起。但是 Krishna 给他们的训示是，他们应该留在家里。
And Lord Krishna instructed them that you don't achieve me just by being close to me physically.
主 Krishna 就对他们训示道：“你并不是通过亲身的跟我在一起，你就是你们就跟我更加接近了。”不是。
Some people they give a lot of importance to the physical presence, to being near, to being beside, close to someone physically.
当然，有些人呢，他们非常强调这种亲身的，能够很近距离的在一起。
But sometimes we see, just like the king may sit on the throne, and some bug or some insect may come, or some bee may come, and may sting, may bite. The bugs may bite the king.
就好像有时候我们会看到国王坐在他的宝座上，然后呢，有一些虫子或者有一些蜜蜂会蛰到他。
So they're close, they're very close to the king. They're on his body, but they're just giving him trouble.
所以我们会看到，虽然这些虫子或者是蜜蜂，他们离这个国王很近，但是呢，他们其实给国王带来的只是麻烦而已。
So it's not just being close to Lord Krishna physically, which is important.
所以呢，其实就是跟 Krishna 很亲身的，离他很近，这个身体的距离很近的话，其实并不是那么重要。
While at the same time, such people are very fortunate. There is certainly no doubt about the good fortune of people like Uddhava and Vidura and so on.
但是呢，同时能够离 Krishna 很接近的这些人，无疑是非常幸运的，就好像是Uddhava 或者 Vidura。
But devotional service is not limited to just the few devotees who could have the physical association.
但是奉献服务并不局限于那些离 Krishna 很近的人。并不是这样。
Just like Narottam Das Thakur was a great devotee, but he never met Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
就好像 Narottam Das Thakur， 那么他是一个伟大的奉献者，但他从来没有遇到过亲身的遇见过 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
But he very strictly followed the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
但是呢，他非常严格的去追随了主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的教导。
So following in the footsteps of the great devotees means following their example in devotional service.
所以追随这些伟大奉献者的步伐，便意味着说，在服务当中去追随他们的榜样。
But again, we come. Well, Rupa Goswami, he retired to Vrindavan, so we should also go and retire to Vrindavan.
但是可能有人会说，哦不，Rupa Goswami 他退休的时候就去 Vrindavan 了，所以我们也应该在 Vrindavan 退休。
We said, if it's not possible for you to go to Vrindavan, then you have to build Vrindavan in your own location.
如果你没有办法实际的去做到让自己去到 Vrindavan 的话，那么就意味着说你应该在自己所居住的这个地方来建造一个 Vrindavan。
We can create replicas of the holy places.
那么你可以去制作你可以就是把这些圣地复制到你所在的这个地方。
Just like in Mayapur, we see in the Gaudiya Math Center, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he had a Govardhan Hill constructed there.
就好像在 Mayapur, 在 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur 的这些修院当中的话，其中有一个，他就在那里重新复制了 Govardhan 山。
He had his own Govardhan Hill, and then he had a Radhakund and.Like that, he was recreating the holy places of Vrindavan.
而且不仅有哥巴丹山，还有扎达坤，所以他就通过这样的方式来复制圣地 Vrindavan.
And one of the aims of our Krishna consciousness movement is to recreate the different holy places.
那么其实Krishna 知觉运动的很重要的一个目的就在于说去在各个地方去把圣地复制到当地。
And establishing the deities of Radha and Krishna, the divine couple, and then establishing the worship for them.
并且呢就是去建立对 Radha Krishna 的崇拜建立对他们的服务。
So we bring the deities first of all, and then once the deities come, then you start to create Vrindavan.
所以呢，首先我们把神像带过来，然后当神像来了之后呢，我们就会就会有这样的建立起重建或者重现 Vrindavan。
Just like there's one community of devotees over in southern Ireland. It's called Ira. You know Ira? It's a country, and it's off the coast of England.
那么有一群奉献者，他们呢就是他们是来自英国的奉献者。那么他们就就是在一个叫 Ira 的这个地方来重现了圣地。
So they have an island there. They actually, when Preacher Prabhu was in charge, he purchased this one island.
所以呢，这是一个岛屿。当 Prithu Prabhu 他负责的时候呢，他就去那里去传道。
And so they brought the deities of Radha Krishna there.
所以呢，他们就把 Radha Krishna 的神像带到了那里。
And they have a forest land around the house where they're living.
所以呢，在他们居住的地的这个周围，都是森林。
And so they've recreated all the different 12 forests of Vrindavan.
所以他们重建了 Vrindavan 的12座森林。
And they've also recreated the different holy places of Krishna's pastimes.
而且呢，他们在那里也重建了Krishna 的很多的圣地的这些纪念的地方。
You know, Casey Ghat and Of the gods. Radhakun, Shamakun, Govardhan Hill, all these places are all there in their holy land.
So in their holy land, Radhakun, Shamakun, Keshi gods, all these holy gods are
there. So we want to have that kind of mood to recreate all of these holy places in our own vicinity.
所以呢，我们要有这样的一种心态，要去或者愿望啊，要去重现这些圣地。
So this helps to facilitate the remembrance and meditation on the Lord.
所以呢，这就会协助我们，帮助我们能够更加好的去冥想至尊主。
Srila Prabhupada could go to America, he could be sitting in New York, and he could say, he could tell the devotees, actually, I'm always in Vrindavan.
Srila Prabhupada could go to New York, and he could go to New York, and he could say,
because I'm always thinking of Krishna, so I'm not away from Vrindavan.
因为我总是想着 Krishna， 所以呢，我并没有离开过 Vrindavan。
So our primary regulative principle is to always remember Krishna and never forget him.
所以呢，我们的最重要的这样一个原则，便意味着说，永远记着 Krishna，
永远记着 Krishna。 Vishmartavya najatu krit sarvi vidhi nisedasho etayor eva kinkara. This is the primary regulative principle over all regulative principles.
所以呢，这个原则是在所有的这些规范原则当中最为重要的原则。
Someone may say, "Oh, I'm following regulative principle. I'm a strict devotee."
有人可能会说，我追随规范原则，我是一个非常严格的奉献者。
We want to know how much are you remembering Krishna?
我们想要知道你到底有多大程度上意念着 Krishna 呢？
So that is our success in devotional service when we can fix our mind on Krishna.
所以这就是我们在 Krishna 直觉当中的成功，便意味着说，当我们能够把心念心专注在 Krishna 上的时候，就意味着我们成功了。But
we don't want just simply to sit and remember Krishna. We want to be actively engaged in the service of Krishna.
但是呢，我们并不想只是坐在那里去一个劲儿的想着 Krishna， 我们想要非常活跃地处于对 Krishna 的服务当中。
If we simply sit and try to remember Krishna, then we will get obstacles. We'll come across obstacles, difficulties in the path.
如果我们只是坐在那里一个劲儿地想 Krishna 的话，那么毫无疑问，我们一定会遇到在这条道路上会有很多的障碍会冒出来。The
mind is not mature. The yogi is not yet mature to practice this kind of.
那么因为呢，这个瑜伽师，他的这个心念呢，还不够成熟到这样的程度，去以这样的方式来冥想 Krishna。
So Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati, he chastised people who tried to renounce prematurely.
所以 Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasati Thakur呢，他会去责备这些在不成熟的情况之下，或者是过早的在不成熟的状态之下要去弃绝的这样的一些人。
Too meek is a Vaishnava, pratishtha nakare nirjanera gari tava hari naam kevala kaitav. What kind of Vaishnava are you?
你是什么样的 Vaishnava 呢？
Just for false prestige, you go away from the world and you want to sit in some secluded place.
你只是为了得到一些在这个世界的虚假的名望，去到一个偏僻的地方，坐在那里。
Better you take up some active devotional service.
最好呢，你还是做一些积极主动的去做一些奉爱服务。
So join the Sankirtan movement.
加入 Sankirtan 的运动吧，加入祈颂圣灵。
Go out and preach, distribute Krishna consciousness.
走出去，去传播，去分享 Krishna 知觉。
Don't simply sit and try to remember Krishna.
不要只是在那里，只是在那里坐在一个地方，想要去意念 Krishna.
Unless you're a very mature devotee.
除非你是一个非常成熟的奉献者。
But if we can actively engage in Krishna consciousness, that will protect us from these kind of obstacles.
但是，如果我们能够非常活跃的处于奉爱服务当中的话，这就可以帮助我们来很好的来避免或者跨越这些障碍了。
So we say the idle mind is the devil's workshop.
我们说一个闲置的心意是魔鬼的工厂。
If you don't keep the mind busy in Krishna's service, then certainly evil thoughts will come in the mind.
如果我们不去积极的把我们的这个心智呢用于对 Krishna 的服务的话，那么很容易的我们就会有一些恶念。
So Krishna consciousness movement is meant for that.
所以 Krishna 知觉运动呢，就是为了这个目的而来的。
To engage everyone actively in Krishna's service.
也就是说，去让每一个人都能够非常活跃的从事奉爱服务。
Okay, any questions?
看一看大家有什么问题吗？
Yes.
大家都同意是吧
？So, what service are you doing for Krishna?
所以你们在为 Krishna 做什么服务呢
？Chanting Hare Krishna.
念诵圣名。
You should go out and chant.
你们应该走出去唱诵。那么这个星期六呢，我们有这个祈颂圣灵，对外的祈颂圣灵。
Maharaj, sometimes people will ask, you have so many philosophy, but this is your own scripture. Different religion is a different scripture.How can I know and so much time to read all the scripture and know who is the real one?
有时候
my friend
Maharaj, 有时候呢，就是有人会问，其实是我的一个朋友就会问我说：“你看你们这个 Krishna 知觉的话，有那么多的经典要去读，才能知道你到底在讲什么你的这个哲学是什么。那么就是说，在这个世界上有很多的宗教，每门宗教呢，他们都有很多的经典那么如果我想要找到属于我的这个灵性的道路的话，那我。是不是要去读所有的宗教的所有的经典的话，那不是很实际，我怎么能够去面对这样的情况呢？然后呢，他说我看了你们的这个博迦梵歌，那 Krishna 是你们的神，但不一定是我的神。
But there's no contradiction between our scriptures and other scriptures.
但是呢，在我们的经典和其他的经典之间呢，其实并没有冲突。
Just like Bhagavad Gita. What is the teachings of Bhagavad Gita and what's the message in the Quran or in the Bible, these books? the message is actually not different.
所以呢，我们会看到《摩迦梵歌》给我们带来的讯息和《可兰经》圣经给到我们的信息并没有冲突，或者没有太大的区别。
I met this one man in Calcutta. He was a Muslim man. He was a vegetarian, and he wrote a book, the Bhagavad Gita and the Quran.And he showed the comparison, the similarities between the Bhagavad Gita and the Quran.
那么，我遇到这样一位，一个人，他呢，就是说，是，他是来自于，来自于加尔各答的。然后呢，就是说，他写了一本书，就是去把《可兰经》，他来自就是穆斯林这个背景，可能是他就把。可兰经和博加梵歌做比较，就把他们之间的这个共同之处都提出来了。
And the Christian Bible also teaches us to love God.
而在基督教当中的话呢，圣经也是教导我们去爱神。
The Bible is teaching people also the kind of qualities which are all mentioned there in Bhagavad Gita.
所以呢，就是圣经里面的提到的很多点的话，其实在《博迦梵歌》当中也都有涉及。
So we don't see any contradiction.
所以我们并没有看到太大的冲突。
But we get a lot more information in our books than what we get in the other books.
但是呢，与其他的经典相比的话，在我们的经典当中，我们会得到更多的讯息。
And I notice also better teachers, better speakers, better maharajas, the explanations, because I have been to, of course, Roman Catholic Church, born into it, but they never gave much information.
那 Lina 就说呢，同时我也意识，我也发现，就是说，在我们 Krishna 知识运动的话呢，我们有更好的老师来讲述这些经典。我自己本身呢是天主教徒，所以在这个天主教里面的话呢，相比下来，我觉得毫无疑问是在 Krishna 知识当中有那么多的 Maharaj， 有那么多的非常好的经典的阐释者。
Yeah, I mean, there's many practical points which we can learn from Krishna consciousness, which we don't get so easily in the other traditions.
是的，在 Krishna 知觉当，在 Krishna 知觉当中呢，在我们的经典当中有非常多的实际的这些要点，是在其他的这些修行当中或者其他的宗教当中，他们是没有提及的。
These scriptures also they get abused. Like sometimes you get fanatical Christians or fanatical Muslims, and they will take sections from the scriptures and they'll utilize them for their propaganda.
有时候呢，我们可能会看到有一些极端的基督教徒或者极端的穆斯林教徒的话，他们会对我们的这个经典断章取义，然后呢去用于他们的这些宣传或者怎么样。
And of course, even in our own tradition, you get these things happening.
当然在我们自己的这个传统当中或者传承当中的话，也有类似的事情发生。
There's so many different versions of the Bhagavad Gita.
在对博迦梵歌的译注呢，其实有那么多的不同的版本。
Most of them are impersonal versions.
而大多数的博迦梵歌的这些译注的话呢，都是非人格的。所以汽车妈询问到呢，那我们可不可以说我们的这个经典是最权威的呢？
韦德。
韦达经是最权威的，
Well, Bhagavad Gita is not strictly Vedas. Bhagavad Gita is Smriti, you know, and the Vedas are the four Vedas.
但是我们严格的意义上来说的话呢，《薄伽梵歌》并不属于伟大文献，《薄伽梵歌》是属于 Smriti。
The Smriti, the Puranas, the Bhagavatam, they're all Smriti.
那么 Purana, Bhagavatam, 他们都是属于 Smriti.
They're the supplements of the Vedas.
那么他们是属于伟大文献的辅助。
But we explain that these supplements of the Vedas are more important than the Vedas because it's very difficult to understand the Lord through the Vedas.
但是我们说这些Puranas 或者 Bhagavatam 他们虽然是辅助的但是就是说这些辅助的这个经典的话甚至比伟达文献更加的重要因为呢当我们要去自己去读这些伟大文献的话其实是很难读明白、
This is also said in the Brahma Samhita In Brahma Samhita Lord Brahma He says Vedeshu durlabham adurlabham atma bhakto It's very difficult to know the Lord through the Vedas But easy to know him from the devotee
所以呢在Brahma Samhita 也就讲到说要去就是说真正的理解主是非常难的但是一个人可以通过他主的奉献者要去理解至尊主的话就很容易、
The Vedas is more emphasizing karmakandi activities
而且呢伟达文献它更多的强调的是karmakandi 的这些活动就是这些业报支部的活动
And only briefly they speak about the higher practice of the Vedas
所以伟达文献它只是非常简略的讲到了就是说这些超然的道路
Okay, Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam ki
jai. Jai. Nrisimha Maharaj ki jai.
Lord Bhaktivrinda ki jai.